This episode contains adult language, mature situation, young witches with hearts of gold, extended family members taking care of each other, mysterious spirits, evil plant life that shrieks loud noises, and everyday slice of life situations. Listener discretion is advised. Episode 289. Hey, this manga looks oddly familiar. Hello everyone, welcome to another episode of the Spiraken Manga Review, some podcasts and fan reviews about connectly enhanced narratives. This is your host Zan saying konnichiwa, aloha, buongiorno, and what's up? Yes, we're back for another fun-filled episode of the Spiraken Manga Review. Hope you guys are doing good. I'm doing pretty awesome, and more importantly than that, I am so excited because it's only, well, it's only a week until Avengers, and more importantly than that, it is 11 episodes until episode 300 and our 10-year anniversary, so I'm so excited. We're almost there, and we're going to make it. One way or another, we're going to make it, even if I have to work my ass off and read everything and review it early. We're going to get this done. But if you're joining us for the first time, welcome. Spiraken is a podcast that provides informative reviews about connectly enhanced narratives. Every episode, I'll talk about one or two manga titles and tell you about them. The pros, the cons, their art style, the characters, the plot, the narrative itself, and if it's worth investing your time in or if you should avoid it like the plague. Now, you don't have to get anything that I say, but I try to be informative, educational, entertaining, and impartial, so not too bad. And I'm always willing to listen to your criticisms and comments. You can email me personally at xan, that's Zan, at Spiraken.com. Zanspiraken.com. You can see that in the show notes. Also, you can check out any of our earlier episodes at www.spiraken.com. We are on Facebook, Twitter, Tumblr, Instagram, Apple Music, Spotify, Player.fm, Stitcher, YouTube, and several other social media sites. Just type in Spiraken in Google and you'll find us one way or another. Also, if you are following us on any of those social media sites, thank you for following us. And remember to direct message me, tag me, or do anything possible that would help promote this podcast. If you're looking for the hashtag is hashtag Spiraken or SMR podcast. Now, with that in mind, hey, you gotta move. I know that there's a kitty in this manga, but you gotta move over. Sorry, the cat known as Maddie has decided to sit on top of my keyboard. So come on. There you go. She's moved. So, with that in mind, let's get actually into the review of the episode, because if you remember, in the last episode, episode 288, I spun that one, that only the wheel of manga, and it dictated unto me that I'd be reviewing a manga that was written by Chihiro Ishizuka in 2012, and it's still coming out to this day. So 2012 to the present. There are six volumes. It was released by Kodansha, and it's brought over here by Vertical Comics, even though it's not a Send in series. It's a shoujo series, so I'm surprised that they released it under the Vertical brand. But it does fit the brand, and it fits the universe. It's something a little bit different and unique, and I like that. It is a shonen comedy series, and more importantly than that, it is a series which seems to have some interesting similarities to a movie that was made by Hayao Miyazaki back in the 80s that involved a similar character with similar background and side characters. And the manga we are talking about today is Flying Witch, or Flying Witch. And so, Flying Witch by Vertical Comics and Kodansha is the story of Makoto Kawata. She is a young witch in training who has decided to go on her journey. She is now at the point in her life when she has to go off on her own and learn and study her abilities and just be a person of her own merit. And so what she's done is she decided to move to Hirosaka Amori. That is where she's going to live and move. It's a small mountain community that's very far away from most other things. And she's going to live there and just train. And so this manga follows her and her cat, Chito, who is a not Chito, C-H-E-E-T-O, C-H-I-T-O, so Chito or Chito, as they learn magic and she lives her life. This is a slice of life story. And, you know, her day is her preparing potions, learning some spells or trying them and ruining them horribly, her meeting various spirits, and her interacting with her family. Because she's living with her extended family, her cousins and her uncles. The big people she interacts with besides her uncle, Keiji, and Aunt Nana are her cousins. Her older cousin, Kei, who you could kind of think that there might be something romantic going on. I don't really see it. I just see them as cousins. And then there's his little sister and her little cousin, Chinatsu. Now, Chinatsu, first, when we meet her, she's a little girl who finds out her older sister is a witch, so she should be afraid of her. She's going to turn her into a newt. But then she ends up liking her cousin when her cousin shows the wonders and marvelous nature of magic. Specifically, they go to a mall and they're walking around. She's kind of bored. And then she discovers that her cousin has the ability to fly. And they go on a flying ride on a broom. And suddenly she's fascinated with magic and she loves it. And she constantly wants her to do magic and she eagerly watches. And she just wants to see all these things that involve witchcraft, supernatural elements. And she is just a very sweet, endearing character. And she also likes sweets. I'm guessing that in the future, later mangas, she's going to become her apprentice. But I don't know. I could be wrong. Now, there are some other characters involved. There is the neighbor girl who owns the sake shop, who becomes her best friend, that is now. And she ends up finding out that Makoto is a witch because she ends up telling her she's a witch. And he's like, wait, aren't witches not supposed to say that you're not a witch? Oh, crap. Yeah, ignore that. But you're doing witchy stuff. Don't worry. We'll be friends. Okay, cool. We're friends. Because now is interested in Kei and she gets jealous of the cousin, but the cousin really has no need. She also, Makoto also has a little bit of a, I hate to say it, she has a Ryoga complex. She gets lost very easily. So nice little running gag with her. She gets lost a lot. And the first volume is just her living her life and adjusting to her new environment and dealing with various spirits and other items. Like when Nao and her become friends, she ends up discovering a mandrake plant and she wants to give it to her as a gift. Now, if you never heard of a mandrake plant, I remember them from the old mythology stories, but in the modern day, you know about mandrake plants because of Harry Potter, because Harry Potter and all of the other kids at Hogwarts had to plant them in Hogwarts. They had to take them out of the ground and then put them in a bowl. Mandrake plants are these little plants that look like people that scream, and they can kill you if you hear their scream. So she gets this plant to give to her friend, even though this thing could potentially kill her. It's like, oh, here, this is a good luck for you. It's like, this is horrific. So she ends up giving it to Chinatsu, who does something with it. There's also this wandering spirit that she sees who becomes her friend. He looks all scary and evil, but he's just the spring of the spring harbinger. He's the god of the spring, and he looks like death from Soul Eater. And you're like, what the hell? He's like, no, that's just death from, that's just not death, that's the harbinger of spring, and he's a good guy. Also looks kind of like Satchel, the third angel from Eva, but I digress. And they just, it's them having tea and relaxing, then him blessing Chiatsu, because Chiatsu's afraid of this big, scary, black creature thing that's bothering them. But besides all these little side sub-characters and little subplots, the whole story is just a simple slice-of-life story that is drawn beautifully. Chihiro Ishizuka has a very unique style of drawing that fits this world so well. And while it is very reminiscent to Kiki's Delivery Service with the premise a young witch is going on a training mission and she ends up in a small town, there are some great differences to it. And you see the elements that work so well. And you see the art style that works just beautifully. The backgrounds, the characters, and the magic is a very unique style to it. It's got a nice little flavor to it. It's not overpowering and crazed. It's simple and just, it flows. I like that. It has a very zen-like quality that's very similar to some of the paintings from Mushishi, but it's more for this series itself. However, if you're not a fan of Slice of Life series, if you want something with a little more action or a little more gumption and a little more speed, this is not the manga for you. It's probably not the anime for you either, because it's just, it goes along at a very simple pace. It doesn't speed up, and there's no overarching plot to it. It's just a slice of life series that has some comical elements to it. And while that's nice and great, and it's a great introductory series, it doesn't bring much new to the table. It brings the standard, everyday, simple uses to it, and I wish it did so much more. I wish it did a lot more with this series, but unfortunately, it doesn't really do much else. It's very similar, like I said, to Kiki's Delivery Service, and while that is a good thing, it's also a pretty bad thing as well, because it's just really representative of other series. It's just, it's not copying, but it's not original. And for that reason, I'm going to have to give Flying Witch, while it is a good, heartwarming series, a gift from your crazy Aunt Muriel. It's okay, but it's very forgettable. If someone has never seen Kiki's Delivery Service before, or has never seen any of the old magic series, give this one a try. It's a great introductory series. However, it's not an amazing introduction to the series. Check it out if you have a chance. It's a decent read, and I'm probably going to be giving away my copy of this at Anime Next, I think, because I don't see myself reading further into it. I could be wrong, and Vertical, if you guys prove me wrong, let me know what I'm missing. If you disagree with me, if you think Flying Witch is the best thing ever, email me, zan@spiraken.com, and tell me why you think it is better. So, with that in mind, you can check out any of our earlier episodes at Spiraken.com, and let's get to the part you've all been waiting for. And what am I talking about? I'm talking about that one, that only, the Wheel of Manga! Yes, friends, the Wheel of Manga, except no substitute. What is the Wheel of Manga? The Wheel of Manga is a Wheel of Fortune with 10 slots on it. And each slot has a manga title connected to it. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to spin the Wheel of Manga. And whenever a number lands on this, we're reviewing the next episode of the Spiraken Manga Review, episode 290. 10 away from episode 300. So we are almost there. And we've got some great titles. And we have a bunch of new Vertical titles that I picked up at Anime Boston. So we'll see if we get one of those. We might get one of those. Or we might get one of the weird ones I picked up too. Because I've got all new stuff. I've got stuff from Vertigo, stuff from Kodansha, stuff from Viz, and then I have this really weird one that I found in a used bin, which I never even heard of before. I'm like, this looks weird. So let's spin and see what we're going to review in the next episode, shall we? Okay, number 8. Cool. So in the next episode, I'm going to be reviewing a Moteki, the new series by Vertical Inc. So this should be pretty good. They were talking about this at the Vertical Inc. panel. They were really pushing this one, and it is a 2-in-1 volume, so it's an omnibus style. So I'm intrigued to see how this one is. So I'll read it, and we'll review it in the next episode, episode 290, on April 20th. So, I guess that's it for this episode. Catch you guys next time. Hope you have a great week. And this is Roseanne. I'm Gonzo. Read more manga.